The MaddK Studio Show.
MaddK Studio Podcast. I'm Ken Madden, your host right now. I have got Christian Rieck with me. We'll talk about Christian in just a minute. We'll bring him in. Today, we're going to talk about entrepreneurs and how they need a place to develop their business, talk with other entrepreneurs. And that place for me has been Jason Stapleton created something called the Nomad Network a few years ago. I've been a member since, well, it started. I think I was one of the first 10 there. Anyway, that was a great place to meet a bunch of other folks that have the same passion for building a business, learning marketing skills, asking questions of each other. Literally networking in a place where there was no politics, there was no selling. You couldn't advertise your wares. You could certainly talk about what you were doing and how you were going to sell it, but you couldn't really advertise your wares, and which is what made it a great, great place. And there was a couple thousand people on there, and I made some great friends all over the world. And it's been a cool thing. But I thought, you know, what would be nice is to have a place for all these folks to bring their wares over, their businesses, and have a place to sell them and practice what we've been working on the Nomad Network in our marketing strategies and whatnot. So with that, I started with an idea of creating a group on Facebook, and it's called Nomad Net Market. Good one there. It's called it's the Nomad Net Marketplace. It's been a long weekend, folks. But in there, you'll be able to advertise your wares, put links to your website. You want to put a video up about what you're doing. I plan on doing some interviews with the nomads that I've worked with quite a bit on the network, and even some of the ones that I haven't. And I'd imagine we'll at some point get Jason Staple himself to come on with us. And so today we're going to spotlight what Christian does. And Christian does voiceovers. He does all kinds of different editing. And I will let him tell you exactly what it is. But anyway, this is Christian Rieck. And truth be told, I didn't meet him on the Nomad Network. I dragged him into it, but I didn't meet him there. Christian and I used to be neighbors and got to be very good friends. And we've worked together on a bunch of different things. So anyway, Christian, welcome. Thank you. And tell everybody what you do.
Well, everyone, my name is Christian. And for years, Ken and I have known each other. We actually were neighbors for a long time. We used to hang out whenever we got the chance, being social, just, you know, good, friendly neighbors. In the time I've been working, I found that I have a talent for putting together easy, well, making them look easy, at least. I'm a producer. I'm the guy behind the guy. So I do a podcast production at work. And there's two different people. I clean up their podcast. They and aw like crazy. They have all kinds of other crutches they use and things they do that I have to fix for them. But I take care of it. I make them sound great. Video and editing, too, is another thing I do for us. I can make explainer videos that are easy, that are super, super good at driving your funnel deeper and deeper. Oh, wait a second. Is that how they work? I don't know. In my job, we don't use a funnel. We don't sell.
Well, explainer videos, I mean, they're certainly useful in funnels. You don't know what's...
No, right.
I mean, you have to have that. You know, one of the things that the internet does that's great is visuals, you know? So a picture is worth 1,000 words. Well, if you put some words with those 1,000 words that is in the picture, you have a pretty compelling strategy to, you know, market what you're doing. And so someone has to create that. And that's a creative process, no different than a piece of art or a piece of music. You can do it well, or you can do it poorly. If you do it well, they're very effective.
One of the things I've found, and this is from painful experience, there is a way to do explainer videos that works. It's easy if we do it right. I'm not a big fan of doing things the hard way. So I have taken us from the hard way to the easy way. And now we put out explainer videos and they work great. We do so much online with explainer videos that I don't have to spend time fighting with clients about all their issues at work. It's just easy now. So it's good. But basically audio and video editing. I guess I also do website work too. I figured out how to edit in websites with Elementor, which works great.
Oh, sure. Yeah, I haven't used that yet, but I know a lot of people really like that program. Oh,
if you're going to start a website and you want to kind of sort of try to fight with it yourself, getting an Elementor subscription for one site costs a few bucks. Worth every penny. And once you figure it out, like I have, it's really, really easy.
So what is it? I guess, like I said, I've never used it. My site, madkstudio.com, is set up with WordPress. And really? I started there not knowing an effing thing about creating a website. And it works. But boy, it's a deep, deep rabbit hole of what you can do. That's overwhelming.
If you've only worked in WordPress so far and what WordPress can do, if you go get a one website subscription, it'll cost $50, $100 a year. And you get it uploaded and you go work on it. You're going to say, wow, I should have done this a long time ago.
Does it have retail capabilities in it and stocking and all that kind of stuff?
All the stuff you want to do, the Elementor people work hard to make sure that it integrates with the entire, well, I should say the entire, probably most of the themes you can pull through in WordPress.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of the other, like WooCommerce or the other apps that could be out there.
Sure. Yeah, WooCommerce is the one I use. Use WooCommerce and I use Stripe for credit cards, PayPal, of course.
Integration is amazing and it's so easy. You just have to go in and play with it a bit and then you'll figure out how it works.
Yeah, no, that sounds cool. Like I said, WordPress is, I like the site. It's been stable as all get out. But when I want to go in and change themes and do stuff like that, it's a little bit, it gets a little cumbersome.
One thing, make sure you set your updates to occur only when you tell it to.
Right.
The reason I say this, I have had problems with some of our websites where an update will occur and it will cause everything to stop.
Yeah.
Because there's suddenly something going on that doesn't work. And then we have to go back and revert to the prior episode or version and then go and fix it and go. It just, so manual updates are the key. But yeah, this is so easy. We live in the future. If you want to, you can learn how to do this. Or if you just want to do your content, you can talk to me and I can help you put it all together so that you have good, professional looking content. Hey Ken, can I just take a minute and vent? Do you mind?
Go ahead. Oh, crack the vent open. It's getting a little stuffy in here.
Ladies and gentlemen, there are a number of you out there who can make amazing content. The problem is, you're trying to do it all by yourself. You have potential. You just don't know how to yet. You haven't figured out how to fully execute your vision. So what you end up with is a mess. You need to find somebody who can help you take the mess and tame it so that your real vision can come out. You got to find somebody like me who can take your real vision and help distill it down to its real essence and go from there.
That is a good point. Content creation, you know, of people that know me know I also work at Xero, and I was there from the beginning, from day one, when we first opened the doors and developed new product. And we didn't do any videos or anything for probably a year and a half, even into our deal. And then we started doing them. And we started doing them with this kind of 10-year-old DSLR camera that had the big chip on it, that the big slide. It wasn't even the micro SD card. It was just the big, almost a floppy disk, almost. And, you know, the thing would always, it would hunt with the focus, trying to focus on you. We had a shotgun mic on the top of it that wasn't the best. And we were standing in a room that was really echoey. And, boy, compared to what we're doing now with, you know, everything's mic'd properly. We've got great cameras. We've put up sound walls and things. It's so much better. Had we started out in the, you know, spent the extra time and energy and money to, and it wasn't much money. I mean, we don't have tens of thousands of dollars into this setup we've got. I mean, we use the Rode Wireless Go 2 mics, the $300, and they're, and you have a set, I have a set. We got a set at work.
They're on the floor. You see my messy office. They're on the floor over there.
Yeah. Mine are on the floor over here in my messy office. But in a bag on the floor. But anyway, you know, I ended up recently looking back on some of those videos that we did back 6-7 years ago, and they are horrible, but they've got 15,000 views, 20,000 views, 30,000 views. They worked. So as you go, you know, don't ever let the perfect be the enemy of the good or even the crappy, because in the beginning, no one sees them. So no one sees them. It doesn't matter. You can leave them up there, and then you've got something when you get better, you can say, look where we started from. And that is something that if you work with someone like Christian in the beginning, even if it's just at a consultation level of, hey, how do I do this? Or what mic should I buy or whatnot? There's another guy, Drew Holmes from thepodcastingstore.com. He's on the network. And one of the things we did is during COVID is kind of when this network all came to be, because it was like, what does everyone do when they're out of work? Well, now's the time to start your business, right? And Drew Holmes had a company that serviced instruments for schools. All right. So, and it's a major big business he's doing over in Colorado. So trombones and tubas and wind, you know, and he'll repair them. He'll rent them out. And, you know, he's the guy that you go to if you're going to rent a saxophone so your eighth grader can play, you know, and then he drops it. It's dented. It goes to Drew. He fixes it, gets it back. All of a sudden, his whole business model evaporated because there was nobody going to schools for a whole year. I mean, his whole model just disappeared. So he also was teaching teachers how to create videos and do instructional kind of things for lessons and lesson plans and things like that, because they're teaching, the kids have to learn how to play the instrument. And so you could do that virtually, even during school and before COVID. So he had the knowledge of that. So he started the podcasting store right at that time, so he could start selling podcast equipment to the teachers that needed it. Cause all of a sudden now they were teaching from home, online classes. And can you imagine how horrible that would have been? Like, you probably don't have to imagine, cause you have kids that were probably in school at the time. It was like, how can you even watch this?
For what it's worth, my kids went to a private school at the time. And because I'm me, when it came time and all this stuff was going on, I went to them and said, hey guys, what are you going to do? Please let me help you. Let me tell you what webcams you need for the classrooms. Let me tell you what you need so this is right and easy. Because there's an easy way and there's a hard way.
Was this in Minnesota or was this in the Dakotas?
This was back when I lived in Andover, Minnesota.
Okay. So another thing that's another fun fact about Christian and I, we have both escaped the Commonwealth of Minnesota. I went east to Wisconsin and he went west to the land of the free. South Dakota. It was kind of a bad deal. We both left about the same time. You were a couple months ahead of me, I think. But it was, boy, after this last election, I'm glad we did. But anyway, this is getting off subject. But
and you said no politics.
I didn't say no politics. I said there's no politics in the Nomad Network.
Oh, that's what it was. Yeah,
I can talk politics on my podcast all I want. And sometimes I will. And I guarantee you, no matter what side of the aisle on, you will be mad at me and also agree with me, because I don't give a crap about the parties at all.
Well, if you have a discussion about reasonable, logical ideas, that is a good place to start with a lot of things, whether it's podcasting, whether it's teachers trying to teach children remotely in schools, or whether it's politics, a little
bit. Start with alignment.
Common sense and reasonable thought are a great place to start with all three of those.
Yeah, no, I agree. But anyway, so let's get back to the school. So did you end up going into the schools and actually being helping them? Did they listen to you?
Oh, no, they did, because I had already shown them. I also am a sound engineer, kind of. At church, I was a volunteer, and I took their digital way over the top digital board they had, and I set it up so good that nobody actually had to sit at the board in church and handle the board.
Oh, that's great.
Board took care of itself. So I helped them with, I showed them with that I can do, or I have the background such that if I offer suggestions on things, they are at least something you should think about. So I simply suggested little things. Like, for instance, the Logitech 920 camera is a wonderful webcam.
Mm-hmm.
Hyper, hyper predictable and dependable. And cheap. It's like $80 now. It'll do 1080 no problem. That's what I'm doing right now. It's so easy. That, and I suggest actually the Rode Goes. I tried to get them to get a couple of those. I think they ended up just using the Logi 920 webcam is so good. Most of them just use that.
We've got that. We use that at work quite a bit when we do Zoom calls. If we're doing like in between employees, when we're doing Zoom calls with not that people don't matter, but like outside business people we want to try to impress. We set up in our studio. We've got a nice Sony A7, a brand new one.
Well, if you can,
and it's 4K, and it's just awesome. But I'm using right now, I use an Elgato. This is an Elgato. There's no mic in it. It's just a camera. But it also comes with an app where you can adjust all kinds of different parameters like you would in a real camera. So you can do, color temperature. It can be automatic. I've got it set to color temperature right now. You can do real sharp, or you can sharpen or it's almost like having Photoshop for your webcam. And I really like it because with showing art and stuff, I need to be able to change things. And this has been a great camera for it, but there's no mic. So the mic I use is this Samsung Pro. And I like this because doing music in the back here, you can see for the people that are watching, there's two plugins here. This one here is my headphone. But the one under it, this is a 1/4-inch plug. Now I've got an electronic drum set in the other room so I can make my own sounders and my own, my intro music. And I can plug that direct into this mic and I can talk and play at the same time while having the phone music come through the drum set, through the mic, play to it. It's just technology. This mic here is $139.
Well, Ken, I don't know how to break this to you. And listeners, you too. We live in the future. Right now.
If we had a sounder button of like some Star Wars stuff, it'd be kind of cool right now.
Let's see what I can do.
Let's see what you can do about that.
And I've said this to people before. We live in a time that is amazing. Right now, because of the market and all of the things going on in the background, people are willing to spend money on gear. And because of that, the want to spend money on gear, you can get gear for cheap that is so good. People will wonder if you're really in a studio. Ken, your Samson mic there?
Mm-hmm.
It's a great mic. It's digital.
Yep.
In USB. My Rode NT1.
Mm-hmm.
This one. I'm going to geek out. Can I geek out?
No, go ahead. Talking about equipment is never a bad thing. I always enjoy it. I know people like to hear about it. So
if you go and watch most podcasts that have, a video cast, what do we call that? A vlog?
Vlog, which I hate.
You're going to see them all using the same microphone.
Mm-hmm.
That microphone that they use is almost $400.
Right.
And the microphone that they're using is not as good as the microphone that I'm using.
Mm-hmm.
Mine cost less than $200.
Right.
This is about the gear. Now, the reason everyone buys that other mic is because everyone buys the other mic.
Right.
It's the go-to mic, and it's a good mic. I'm trying to think if it's an SM7, I think. I forget now. Is it a Shure SM7?
Sure. Yeah, sure. Sure makes those.
It's about a $400 mic, and it's a good mic.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't make a sound this good. Rode, R-O-D-E, out of Australia. Oi, mate. Another mic on the Barbie.
They're incredible. They're wireless mics for doing outdoor stuff.
Rode Go. If you don't own a Rode Go and you do any kind of work with content, if you don't own one, go to sweetwater.com and buy one.
Right go now. Go to thepodcastingstore.com. Go to our guy Drew.
Okay.
Because here's the deal with those. The price on those doesn't vary much.
Hmm.
Pretty much everywhere it's $300 for a set of Rode mic for the wireless go-tos. I would recommend the wireless go-to hands down, spend the extra money, because the number two gives you two mics, and each one actually records up to 7 hours you can set it to record in each microphone. So if you lose connection somewhere or something messes up in your phone or whatever, you've got a backup recording it in the mic, then you just download it and use it again. And it's you can do high lows because you can have a what do you call that when you have one track that's 10% lower in gain than the first track. It's just a safety track.
Well, the nice thing about having multiple tracks is if you hand them off to a person like me, I can throw them into my editing software. I can fix it.
Right.
If you hand me a track with two people on it, and it's one track and there's two people,
there's not much you can do.
A whole lot louder than the other. I'm going to tell you, you screwed up. I will do the best I can.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be shit.
Right.
But if you give me a good starting point with two tracks, I'll make it sound like a winner.
Well, also, what we're doing right now, we're recording this in Zoom. So I still think that that's still the best software out there that's reliable. In Zoom, when you're setting up your meeting, you can set it up so there's two tracks. So right now, Christian and I, when he's editing, and this is how I'm gonna talk about this in a minute, he'll be able to have each of us on our own track. So the ums and ahs and things like that, or the modulations, if the sound's different, he'll be able to equalize that a lot easier because he can take each track individually and equalize it. And in Premiere Pro, it's really easy to do. And if you use
Audition,
I always want to say Audacity, but if you use Audition,
wait. Audacity. You said it.
Yes, I did.
Audacity is amazing software.
It's free.
And it's free.
I use it all the time.
If you are starting out doing any of this stuff, you should. And it's so easy. They, in the past, they had to do two separate parts. One, so you could basically create an MP3. You don't have to do it. One program, one download. Excuse me. One download will get you everything you need, and Audacity will start teaching you.
Yeah.
It works. Audacity is where I started learning audio.
That's fantastic. It's fantastic. So what's the other one? Is it not Fusion 360? What's the other that people, a lot of people are switching over to from Premiere Pro to there's a free version and a paid version. It's a video editor.
Oh, I don't know, because I like Premiere Pro. Oh,
I do too. I do too, but I'm trying to think what the other one is. Anyway,
I'm fighting with Adobe because the software has a significant learning curve, but I've wrestled through enough of it. I'm good enough now where I will just stay with Premiere Pro. And it helps that I figured out a way to get the student discount.
Oh, that's good.
I'm only paying $20 a month.
Oh, that's not bad at all. What I like about the Adobe suite is I do a lot in Illustrator. And I do a lot in Photoshop. So the library in Illustrator and Photoshop is one Adobe library. So I can take all of my logos, artwork, you know, graphics, all that stuff, and just in a library and use it on all three. Mm-hmm. And it just works. And you just drag and drop it in and it works. When you're using the outside ones, you're not, you always have to go out of the program to go grab them and bring them in. And then this has to be a link somewhere. So I'm sticking with the Adobe. I'm like with you. I didn't know what Premiere Pro was until we started doing our videos at work. And I just sat down and I'm like, well, we have the Adobe suite. There's got to be a way to edit videos. So I Googled it. I'm like, oh, let's try this Premiere Pro thing. It can't be too hard. And that's how I started. I just opened it up. And within 10 minutes, I had it figured out how to, okay, here's a timeline. We can put something in here. That's video. This line sound. And I could make a video. Okay, this is how I put type in there. And this is how I put another music in there. Okay. So within 10, 15 minutes of never using it before, I could create a video. Then the rabbit hole opened up, and that is what happens, because like you said, there's so much, and there's Audition. I haven't even touched it yet, because I'm like, I'm not even going to go there. And then After Effects is the other one. And I'm just like, I'm not even going to download it. I don't even want to look at it. There's only so much I can absorb and learn. And I know it's awesome, but I'm going to leave that to other people.
I'm actually going to use After Effects in editing this video when we get it done. Audition is also another one I'm going to edit, because what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to play with the audio and I'm going to rework it so we sound like we're talking to each other instead of just two voices talking.
Very good.
Yeah.
So with that, what I will tell everybody is, because Christian and I are friends, we've known each other for a long time, we've only been talking about trying to do something together like this for about 6 or 7 years. And mm-hmm. finally, we decided to do it. And so Christian's going to come on as the producer for the MaddK Studio Show Extravaganza. I think this is episode 13 since 2020. So I've gotten right on being consistent in not making podcasts. So here's to me.
Here's to you being consistent.
Here's to Christian. And check out madkstudio.com. That's my artwork website. The Nomad Network, all you Nomad people out there, I want you to come and contact us. You can just email me, ken@madkstudio.com, madkstudio.com. And Christian, if someone wants to do some video editing or needs some help with something, how can they get a hold of you? Go ahead.
The best way, the easy way, is just send me an email. It's Rieck Enterprises, I'll do it this way. Romeo, India, Echo, Charlie, Kilo, Enterprises @gmail.com. Send me an email. Tell me what you want to do.
Go ahead.
Specifics. No. If you just say, hey, I want to do a video, that's an okay start. I don't need you to give me the storyboarding for what you want to do, because we're something, if you decide you want to work together, we're going to work on that together. Not, I'm just going to throw you out there and say, hey, do all this wild and crazy complicated stuff on your own and then get back to me. Because a lot of this stuff, like we talked about with the software, a lot of this stuff is really complicated. But if you want to start, just send me an email and say, hey, I want to start. We'll work together, figure it out. It's easy.
So I'm assuming that since that you know a editor, video editor, there'll probably be links. There will probably be little pop-ups right around here with my website and over there with your website.
What?
I'm just saying, I bet that could happen.
Well, it's funny to say that, actually, Ken. My website will not appear anywhere, because although I own several domains and I do a website for work, I personally don't have a website.
Come on.
It's so much.
Don't you need one more thing?
I don't want one more thing to do. When you have a website, you've got to take care of it. It's like having a kid.
It is.
It's constant, at least kind of shadowing, Because you can't just let it go and not ever have any interaction with it. You got to occasionally go look at it and see what it's doing.
Oh, tell me about it. I know all about it. Yep. You have to update, download, put up, check on it, make sure things are working. Wonder why five pages just magically disappeared.
Disappeared, yeah.
Because something you did.
Well, I don't have a website because I had one before, or two or three. And I said, I'm tired of fighting with that thing. Just send me an email. If you want to do a podcast, I can help you. If you want to do a video explainer series, I can help with that too. There's a lot of little things. If you just got a question, you can ask. I go too far with people usually, and I will answer questions that I shouldn't answer just because I like to help. So if you've got a thing, what should I do? One warning. Ken will confirm this probably. If you ask me a question, prepare yourself. The answer will probably be long.
Yeah, pack a lunch if Christian's going to answer a question for you, because you will get a detailed, thought-out creation.
If you think it's a 750 answer, bring a 175.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. Well, with that, Christian, I think we're going to end it there. This is a great introduction for everybody to the NomadNet Marketplace, MaddKStudio.com podcast. Thanks for watching, and go ahead and check us out on Facebook. See you later.
Hey, kid. Should I cue the output music now?
Yes.